Well, welcome to Tacoma Calvary. I'm Pastor B, and this is today's Walk in the Light. And today, we're actually going to take a look at a few verses from the book of Colossians, a book in where Paul is writing some pretty serious things about heresy, something that we have to be very, very mindful of. Non-biblical teaching, the error of the way of man and religion and all of these things. And so in this Colossian heresy, Paul was contradicting a lot of things that were taking place, like the basic principles of the world or circumcision. Like adding anything to the gospel is no longer the gospel. It talks about, you know, the traditions of man. Jesus over and over to the Sadducees and to the Pharisees taught against following after the traditions of man. Or that the Sabbath and the food and the festivals are the observance of that for the Christian, or even the worship of angels. And so Paul is writing some pretty serious things here in the book of Colossians to this church of Colossae. And he says in chapter 3, verse number 1, he says, "If then you." And I love that because he writes it as "if then you," like directing it at a person, but yet it's directed to the church. Writing to this church almost 2,000 years ago, he writes the letter. He writes it to them individually, but them corporately as well. But the Holy Spirit is writing it to you and to me. And I love, like in the movies, the depiction of like the Italian gangster. And he goes, "Oh, and hey, and yous." Like he adds an S to you. He makes you plural. In a sense, that's what you're seeing here. If then you, as in one person, as in an individual, but to all people. The Holy Spirit writes it to all people. If then you were raised with Christ. Anytime you're dealing with heresy, the only thing you have to do is you have to go back to the fundamentals of who Jesus is and what it is he came for. And he came to save sinners. He died on that cross. He was buried in the grave. And he rose again on the third day. And if you then were raised with Christ. And I think back to what it says in chapter 2 of Colossians, in verses 11 and 12, it says, "In him you were also circumcised with the circumcision made without hands, by putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ, buried with him in baptism, in which you also were raised with him through faith in the working of God who raised him from the dead." The way you deal with heresy is you go right back to the basics of the very gospel of Jesus Christ. If then you were raised with him, if you and I were raised with him, then it says, "Seek those things which are above, where Christ is sitting at the right hand of God." And I love this because it uses this word to seek. And this word is a verb, to seek, in order to find. It tells us in Matthew's gospel, Matthew 7:7, ask and seek and knock. And here's what I love about that. This is the promise to us. Everyone who asks, receives. And he who seeks, finds. And him who knocks, it will be open to him. And here, if you've been raised with Christ, then you're called to seek those things which are above. Not the things on the earth, not like if I get my promotion or if I get a better home. I mean, those things aren't bad, but listen, as Christians in the Spirit, we are called to seek, verb, action, those things which are above where Christ is. And I love this because the reality is when you think about the things, seeking those things which are above, the first thing is where Christ is. So setting our minds on the things that are above is being in the very presence of God. To set your mind on the things above is to set your mind in the very presence of God. And that's one of the beautiful things that we have. Another thing, seeking your mind or setting your mind on the things that are above is being in the power of the Holy Spirit. So being in his presence, being in the power of the Holy Spirit. We're not left orphans. We have all the help, all the power that we need in the Holy Spirit. Another thing is that setting your mind on those things is to set your mind on eternal things, right? We get so wrapped up in the circumstances of life and the here and now, what's going on here, and yet God has this eternal plan, and we, setting our mind, should be setting our mind on those things so when we come in contact with people, we can share eternal things with them. We can pray for them. We can love them and have compassion and mercy in a different way. Another thing that sets your mind on the things above is serving others. just pure servitude. Jesus said, I didn't come to be served. I came to serve. So again, that's setting our minds on the things above. And then, listen, we're in this world, but we simply are not of this world. And so being in the power of the Spirit, because Jesus Christ died on the cross for us, and we've died with him, and we've been raised with him in all power and all authority, that we now are able to set our mind on those things where Christ is sitting at the right hand of God. And then he says in verse number 2, set your mind on things above, not on the things of the earth, for you died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. And I love this because this is this beautiful picture of us in oneness with God, with Jesus, with the Holy Spirit, right? We set our mind on those things, and yet we are hidden with Christ in God. That is so encouraging to me. And I love the words of the song, My Hideaway, because it says, the arms of God will always be open, waiting here for me. This is where I want to stay, my hideaway. And this is the encouragement that we have today, that again, we have a high priest. We have a mediator. We have a God. We have a Savior. And he's given us everything that we need to live out this life, to live it in godliness and to live it in power, and that we are able to set our minds on the things above, to be in his presence, to be in the power of his Holy Spirit, to set our minds on eternal things, to be servants, and to recognize, listen, we are pilgrims and we are sojourners and we are simply passing through. God bless you guys today. Come visit us at Tacoma Calvary, 1201 South J Street. Find us online at tacomacalvary.org, and we'd love to get to know you. God bless you.